Episode 1289, Make Room in Your Heart.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy day. How is your weekend going? Hopefully, you've had some time off, a chance to take a break. I know you need a break. And you know what? Today, Sweet Spirit Sunday, we're talking about making room in your heart. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and to sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, slowing down to know your priorities is certain to open up opportunities. Make room in your heart and show up. But that slowing down, it's pretty catchy, isn't it? I'm sure you've tried, just like me, saying no in order to say yes to what really matters, what counts. Yet the heart seems torn. The responsibilities can't be deleted, nor can they be depleted. You have to do what you've been given as responsibilities. You just can't say, okay, kids, just go fix your own dinner, and they're 2 and 4 and 6 years old. It doesn't work that way, does it? You got to do what you got to do. And then there's those hobbies and interests. You need to keep your sanity. So why can't you play just a little? Yeah, we all want to play. Plus, then we add in our friends and family. Where's your time and energy now? All this to say, what really has your attention? That's the question I want you to ponder here for just a moment. What in this moment in time, as you're listening to my voice, what has your attention? Is it the dirty dishes in the sink? Is it the laundry that's piled up? You probably have maybe 3 or 4 days worth of laundry yet to fold. Is it the deadlines because school's going to be starting soon? Oh, I know I mentioned that. I'm so sorry, but it's fact. It's going to be happening. Seasons are going to start changing again. And you're like, but I just got into the groove of summer. What really has your attention? Are you making room in your heart for what counts? I know for me, I've been struggling with that personally. Lately, it's been focusing on the move. Well, before that, it was selling the house. Before that, it was preparation to sell the house. And then finally, we sold the house. And then it was preparation to close the deal, right? You have to sign the contract. Even though you've got a contract, you still have to get everything that they want done. And then we had to find a house. And then we had to move. And then we had, like, you know, 2 big, huge trucks. And then I had to make sure that we had places to put everything. And then I had to get the kids into school. And then it was like one thing after another. And now I'm looking at it summertime and I'm going, it's almost school time. Where has all of my time gone? My energy seems to have been given to boxes. Lots and lots and lots of boxes. That's not where I want my heart to be. I made plenty of room to get all that done. But how much have I been giving God? That's what I've been wrestling with. Yeah, I try to fit him in when it works for me. Or I try to fit him in when I need him. I know, yes, I need him every day, but do we really need him every day? Come on, we don't think so. Unless if something's going on, chaos is all breaking up. You know, up north where we moved from, there were tornadoes that touched down. They came out of the blue. At least to my knowledge right now, no one was killed. There were injuries. But that's a scary thing, right? We call on God when we all of a sudden need him here on our earthly planet. But God says, I want you to need me all the time. That's how heaven works. I want to be needed all the time. I want to be a part of your life all the time. But what really has your attention? Are you making room in your heart for what counts, for what matters? God desires your attention, and not just when you feel like it or when you can fit it in. I already told you how I just kind of fit him in when it's convenient for me. Even when you go to church, is your heart in it? We go to church on Saturdays. Sometimes on Sundays, we're still looking for and searching for a church home. But when you go to church, whether it's on the weekends or even during the week, are you really in church? Or are you sitting there planning out the next day's schedule? Are you like, you know, planning the meal times? Okay, I got to make sure when I go to the grocery store, okay, I'm going to flip to my little app here and put in my grocery list. Okay, I need this and this and this. Oh, wait, now I need this, this, and this. And all of a sudden, you've lost and totally gotten misplaced from what the preacher was talking about. You've missed three scriptures, and now you're sitting here going, I don't know. So you go on to doing something else. Oh, you get ding, a text comes through, right? Oh, got to check that. It's important. How important is God to you? What if he was texting you all the time? Where you have all these other interruptions, would you answer? Would you be as quick to respond to him as he does to you? When you go to church, is your heart in it? You got to make room in your heart. Open your heart to being teachable, not just opinionated. We get that way, don't we? If it's not my way, it's the highway. We as parents, it's easy to get opinionated. Why? Because this is what we believe is true. This is how we were raised. So this is what it is. Well, is it what it is? We need to open our heart to being teachable. We need to be lifelong learners. That's what God wants for us. He wants to teach us. He wants to grow us. He wants to develop us. He wants to challenge us. He wants to correct us. He wants to love us. But are you pushing him away? What really has your attention? You know, maybe you're wanting to control your life, being choosy where you spend your time, but how much do you make room in your heart for what matters? You matter. You matter to God. God never gave up on you. He pursues you every single day. However, he does want you to make room in your heart for what he is specifically designing for you. So today, as you are hanging out by the pool or playing with the kiddos, or maybe you're doing some cleaning and catch up on the laundry, doing those dirty dishes that have been sitting there for 2.5 days, that's okay. I won't tell anybody mine too. It's called life, right? It's all right. But I want you to take some inventory as to where you are today. Where would God want you to change your schedule to make room, to make him a priority in your heart and in your actions? He wants to be a part of your life. But in all honesty, what are we doing? We're just pushing him away until it's convenient where we need him. And then we call on him, we cry out to him, and we're all about him. And then when things are going great, it's like, praise the Lord. And then we kind of simmer in to, oh, this is great. And until another turbulence happens, I'm just going to sit right here. Our comfort. Too much. Too little. Make room in your heart. Don't wait for the perfect time. Every single time you're waiting for that perfect time in life, maybe you're working on your business. Maybe you're planning out what's going to happen in 20, 30 years when you retire. I don't know what your retirement plan is. But maybe you're trying to figure out the perfect time, how everything is going to play out in life. When we do that, we're shutting God out as we speak. I know for me, I thought I was doing life the way he wanted me to, and I did some incredible things doing the things that I thought he wanted me to do. However, he had and does have bigger plans. Sometimes I think he's moving a little slow, and sometimes I think he's moving a little fast. It depends on the moment. But I know for me, he has an incredible plan, a heavenly blueprint. That every once in a while, I get a sneak peek into how he is developing it. And then he looks at me and says, and what are you doing? It's time for you to take aim, Christiane. You got to make room. You can't keep piling on more and more stuff. You got to learn to say no, no with a period, not no, well, I'll think about it, and then get back to him. Yeah, I'll do it. It's no, period. It's not in my season. I don't continue. Don't wait for the perfect time, because there is no perfect time for God. God's timing is perfect, not our timing, not your timing. Don't shut him out. I get it. It's easy to get hung up on the details of life. You know, you want to invite friends over for a Bible study, but the house is never clean. When will it ever be? Even though my children are getting older, I still think they make as big of a mess now as they did when they were just little toddlers running around. We were walking out of church yesterday, and oh my goodness, this adorable, she couldn't have been any more than 2 years old, had a little pink sippy cup. I thought, oh, I remember those days. Little blonde girl with, oh, adorable curly hair in the back, just like curly locks. And I was like, oh. And I turned to my husband and I said, you know what? We used to have five of those. And he goes, yeah, we did. But now they're bigger. Sometimes they're not as cute anymore. We have harder things to deal with. When will your home ever be perfect? It won't. Maybe you want to host a celebration for the family, but the living room isn't finished yet. You don't have the pictures up. You're painting. You got a half wall that's, you know, some wallpaper or some nothing. And you're like, I can't have anybody over. It's like, I'm ashamed of my living room. Where will we all sit? Where will we eat? Perfect timing? Really? Maybe you want your girlfriends to come over for a party. You want to host a party. You think it'd be fun. Play makeup or bring out some cooking utensils and just have a blast. Maybe, you know, pour a little bit of wine, whatever floats your boat. But all that means to you is more work. And you don't have time for more work. Stop getting hung up on the details. Because that's when you close the door to God. And when you close the door to God, you're closing the door to heavenly opportunities. You want to intentionally cultivate room and space and margin in your life for God to work. But we're not doing it if we're shutting him out. We're not doing it if we're staying busy. If busy is your favorite word, you need to think again. And I want you to take a hard look. This is why we call it Sweet Spirit Sunday. It's reflections. It's all about you. And this isn't stuff that, you know, is something that we just kind of throw around here at Create Your Now. No. This is stuff that I go through. I'm working through this now going, Lord, I know I need to make more room. What does that look like? Ask him. Say, Lord, what does making room in my life for you mean? What does that look like? How can I formulate and cultivate the space? How can I make room for you so you can show up and then I can show up too? We got to stop getting hung up on these little itty bitty details. Let God major in the minors. We need to major in God. That's who desires our attention most. God wants to grow you. He wants to develop you. But if you keep pushing him out of your schedule, when will you ever have time? When will you ever make time? Make room in your heart. Carve out that space where God is the priority so he can stretch your faith and he can open you up to a heavenly dialogue and can challenge you when you get too comfortable. You must make room in your heart to respond. Maybe you're one who is praying on the go. Well, we're great multitaskers, aren't we, moms? Women, we are. We do an incredible job at multitasking. We can be listening to a podcast, like right now, doing the dishes and cooking dinner and having a conversation. Huh, that is fantastic. And maybe in between there, you say a little prayer. But at what point do you come back and say, Lord, I'm listening. I'm waiting. I'm not moving. I'm silent because I want to hear you. How many times do you kind of use the nighttime after you've got the kids to bed and it's like, okay, finally, I've gone to the bathroom. I've brushed my teeth. I'm laying down. Hopefully the husband is almost snoring so he's asleep and you get peace and quiet for 2 seconds. Oh, wait, then the cat comes up and wants to like snuggle and they're like, go away. And then finally you breathe and you're like, oh, peace, quiet, tranquility. And then you fall asleep. You fall asleep on God. Seriously? Make room in your heart. Now, I am being real and honest with you. You can't get any more real than this, but this is how we lead our life. You may flip on the TV or turn something on Instagram and everybody looks like they've got this perfect life of how they balance their children and how they balance their husband with their career and with God. And they, you know, paste all these things up there, pin them, whatever you want to say. And it looks like they're living this perfect life. But they're not. It's just pictures at a time where maybe they're actually struggling. And they're posting it as a reminder of, I really want that, but I'm not there. Where are you right now? Are you making room in your heart? Because God wants you to respond. But you have to make room in your heart in order to do that. You have to be still. Our comfort must rest in God and God alone. Father knows best. Where are you in your life today, in your season of life? Maybe you are struggling in a particular area. I want you to take it to God. But then I want you to take it a step further. And I want you to make room in your heart to respond to God, to what He says. Because when you're going out there doing whatever you think you're doing, making the world a better place, it's not when you shut Him out. And that's what we're doing. We can't do that any longer. We're missing heavenly opportunities, and those are golden. Make room in your heart today. Pause. Maybe right after you're done listening to this, pause for just, maybe it's only 35, 45 seconds and say, Lord, I want to be open to You. Show me as I walk through my day today, Lord. Show me the doors that I need to close. Show me the doors I need to open so that I can make room in my heart for You. I want to draw closer to You. Cry out to Him today so He can fill your life with what He has in store for you. Because I'm telling you right now, kingdom dreams, oh, incredible, indescribable, because they're from the God Almighty. Go out today and make room in your heart. Be present. Be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.